everybody, and welcome back to my channel. So as you all know, we are going into a national lockdown again for a month this time, and I've been really lucky. I've been asked to play in my second pro challenge series match, and I'm up against Alison Waters. So I thought, what's a better time to vlog what I do before a big match, how I prepare, and what training I'll do before it. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you can, smash a huge thumbs up and please subscribe. So it is about 3:30, the day before my match. Me and Charlie are gonna go down to the club and have a hit on the glass to get some practice on it, as it's so different to a normal court. And yeah, it's really important to get a hit on it before. So yeah, I'm really excited. I already did a squash session this morning with Charlie's dad, Danny Lee. Really grateful for all the opportunities he's given me, training at the club so much, so valuable being able to get on court with him so regularly, and the coaching he does is amazing, and he's created such an amazing community at the club. And yeah, I'm just so grateful for him and all his support. Go and check out the Pro Squash Challenge Series Instagram page and the YouTube channel to go and watch all the old matches that have been played and check out all the results. And that is where you'll find out information about the next matches. Yeah, go check it out. Without further ado, let's go play some squash.
The old journey to the club.
So just did some ghosting, so did 4 sets of 20 shots, not a lot, but a little bit, just to get our footwork going and get our feet moving quickly to and from the ball before our match tomorrow. It's a good thing to practice before a match. It helps get your lungs going and it doesn't fatigue you too much because we didn't do too many sets, but it's a good thing to still do before a match. So now we're gonna get hitting, do some routines and play a couple of games, and yeah, I'll vlog a bit of it.
Session.
Feeling good for my game. My food is here. I ordered another Carluccio's because it is my
bloody favourite.
It's my favourite meal in the world.
Why not?
Pre-lockdown shopping. So I've chilled this evening, watched a lot of TV and relaxed. We went to Lidl and got our weekly food shop.
Other shops are available.
I've got to do a solo in the morning, and then I'm gonna have some lunch at the club, chill outside, get some fresh air, and then get ready for my match. So yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. Good morning, everyone. Just here having my breakfast. I had a some fried yogurt, a banana, a cereal bar, crumbled with some honey and some pineapple juice whilst we are watching Tom play Lucas. It's 2-1 at the moment, so hopefully Tom can come back and win. Charlie, are you feeling good?
Socks. Exciting.
Okay, so I'm going to go to the club now, set up for Charlie and Joe's match. I'm gonna go get some lunch at the club, probably do some video editing, and then we're up. So I'm really excited, it's gonna be so much fun. So right now I'm just gonna go finish off packing up my bag and head over to the club. My lunch. I'm going to give you a retrospective match analysis. I don't know how good I'll be, but yeah, I'm just going to take you through it and see where I thought I could be better at things and what I was very good at and what I wasn't as good at. So yeah, let's give it a watch. Okay, first rally of the whole match. This was a really good rally. It was probably one of the best ones in the whole match, to be honest. Yeah, I was trying to set my stall out quite early on, making it really tough from the first point, which this rally pretty much was. Important, I tried really hard to get a good length before putting any short balls in first. There wasn't a very good length there, it bounced just on the service line, which isn't great. Hit that probably a bit too late. But there again, I got my width back and my depth back. That was a great shot. That was a good get, and that was a great reach. This rally, I can see me smiling because it was just going on for so long. I wanted it to be over. Oh, what a shot. Great volley by me. Okay, so still the first game, 4-1 now. As you can see, I got myself quite a good lead. Going 4-1 up, playing pretty well. I was using a lot of height in this match quite nicely because this court is so fast, and it's really important on this court to get a good height and to slow it down, as because it's so fast you can get stuck and led into a really frantic match. As you can see there, I should have lifted, but instead I hit it low and hard, which made her just put me in a really bad position and lose the rally. That was a good length, and caused her to stretch all the way out the back and made an error. Game ball. Here I was thinking I need to try and make myself really tough this last point. And I played a good rally. She hit a really tight shot there. It's hard on this glass because it sticks to the wall really well if you hit it perfectly. And she hit a really tight shot and it was really hard for me to get it off the wall. 8-10. Good reactions, good volley drop. I hit it with a really good margin, that didn't hit, make an error. So we're in the second game now, 3-1. Probably went a bit too over that because I went over the ball on that a bit too much as it really bounced up again. There was a perfect chance for me to play the ball straight and deep into the back, but instead I tried to make it too showy and tried to hit a good hold cross court, which didn't work, which was really silly. This is a good rally. Oh, yeah, shot. Again, she hit a good tight ball falling into the wall, so it was really tough for me to get. Nine four up, I got a really good lead in this game. Played really well, didn't make many errors, defended the ball really nicely. That's a good drop. There, I should have just tried to hit it straight instead of going cross court. My width there was so poor. retrieving quite a lot of good stuff. That wasn't great. Yeah, shot. She put me in a tough position there to get the ball out the back. Right, 10-5. That was just poor. I should never be going for that shot at that point. That should have been a simple straight drive and continuing the rally. They're good, fair overhit, but it was good because it went all the way to the back and made her have to stretch. This is a good rally, I've got some good balls back, and sadly she got a bit too close to that ball and ended up giving me a stroke. Went too low up. Okay, third game, I went 7-4 down. Probably started making, I made a lot of errors at the start of this game. Oh, shot. Okay, got it back to 9-all. And then it got pretty tight. Probably got a bit too tense, started hitting it all a bit too hard. There, she hit a nice roller. Started getting a bit too frantic, where I just needed to slow the pace down and extend the rallies again, as I knew that was something she was struggling with then. But instead I started hitting the ball even harder, which ended up becoming a lot looser and giving her a lot more chances to hit points just like that. Even then, I was a poor whip and should have just tried to hit a simple straight shot. I went 3-1 down in this game as well. I started with a lot of errors. Managed to get, not great, but I still got it back. There, I should have just tried to lift it instead of hitting it so hard, because there she could have had an opportunity to put me under again more pressure. Yeah, it was a good volley drop. I was putting the volley drop in, backhand volley drop in really well this match. There, see, that's a simple lift that I should have done a couple more times to give myself a lot more time to get on the tee and get ready for the next shot. That was a good shot. Okay, 9-7 down in the fourth. There, that was a nice shot. Had a big area in the back wall to aim for and a lot of space as she hit the ball quite wide, and yeah, executed it quite well. At 8-9 down, I just thought I really needed to make it really tough again and start extending the rallies again. And when I did have that opportunity to just go for it, because she wasn't getting many of my good winners back, and don't know if that was up or not, to be honest, but everyone said it was good, so that's fine. But yeah, got it back to 9-all. She forced an error as a upping the pace quite a lot, making it quite tough. I was getting quite a few good balls back as well. There was one point in that rally where I hit a ball out the back, tried to hit like a cross court stun from the back, and that was the wrong thing to do. I should have just went for a simple straight drive. There, I just caught her off guard. She hit it a bit loose, so I decided to put away quite quickly and executed it pretty well. Okay, so I got myself here to match ball. Really trying to make this last rally really tough. Wasn't a great serve. She didn't hit it very wide though, so it led me to have a good opportunity. I was trying to make this rally really tough, just make sure I'm getting the ball to the back, and then when I had that one opportunity to really go for it. So there, I was quite lucky that it didn't go up, but yeah, I thought I executed that final kill really well. It's quite a good strength of mine, so when I have the opportunity, I do like to go for it. And yeah, that was match. I won my match 3-1. I played really well. I was moving the best I've probably moved in a really long time. So I'm so happy. It was a good match to get under my belt. Sadly, obviously, with all the conditions and everything going on at the moment, it's such a shame that I can't really keep the momentum, but good things are coming. And yeah, I just had a really good time. Played so well, so yeah, I'm super happy. The full video of this match is now up on the Pro Squash Challenge Series YouTube channel, so make sure you go and check it out and give it a watch. There's so many other matches on there that you can go and watch too, with the Lee brothers, myself against Tori Malik, Joe versus Tom Richards, for example. And yeah, they're all great games. And yeah, go check them out. I'll leave the link at the end of my video.
So that concludes my video. I hope you guys have enjoyed it and seen what it sort of looks like to prepare for a big game and what I thought of my match and how I analysed it. Again, I just want to say a huge, huge thank you to Pro Squash Challenge Series for giving me this awesome opportunity to be able to play. I'm extremely grateful because, as you know, there's not many events to play, so it's great to earn some money in other ways. So yeah, I just want to thank Danny for giving me the opportunity, and I want to thank all the sponsors that have put so much effort into making this challenge series work. Please smash a huge thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you so much, guys. See ya.